Can diabetes be reversed? Most people say that once a diabetic is always a diabetic. Not only that, you're expected to leave your favorite food, rely on medicines, and even take daily insulin shots. Besides that, you will also have to go through the complications of diabetes, such as nerve damage, kidney damage, vision loss, amputation, and even heart attack. But do you really need to go through all this? Can you not do something about it? Is it possible to go back to your pre-diabetes life? Let's find answers to these questions. So in this video, we'll discuss what causes diabetes, can diabetes be reversed, how to reverse diabetes. Simply put, diabetes is excess of sugar or glucose in your blood. So where does this glucose come from? The food we eat breaks down into glucose or sugar. Insulin is a hormone that transports glucose from blood to the cells for energizing different body parts. Now, if your body doesn't produce insulin or your cells stop accepting glucose delivery by insulin, the sugar level in the blood will rise drastically. The first condition in which your body produces no or limited insulin is called type 1 diabetes. The second condition is called type 2 diabetes. In type 2 diabetes, the carbohydrate coming from your food and drink are broken into glucose. The pancreas then releases insulin, but the cell somehow becomes insulin resistant. That is, they stop accepting glucose delivery from insulin. Because this insulin is not properly used, the blood glucose keeps rising, so further more insulin is released. For some people with type 2 diabetes, this can eventually lead to tiredness of the pancreas, meaning the body then will make less and less insulin, which leads to even higher blood glucose level. This is called insulin resistance. To summarize, two reasons for diabetes. First, lack of insulin. Second, insulin resistance. Next, let's come to, can diabetes be reversed? Now the question arises that can diabetes be reversed? Can it be kicked out from your life forever and ever? Many of you may be surprised if I answer yes to this question. But trust me, diabetes reversal is possible, though reversal of type 2 is easier compared to type 1. How to reverse diabetes? So how to do it? Well, with some simple and practical methods, you can reverse your diabetes. Diabetes reversal is a journey. You need to go slow and make changes to your diet and lifestyle habits to make this happen. Let's dive into these one by one. We will talk about the diet changes first. The first one is to implement portion control. What do we mean by this? Often we eat a lot more calories or sugar than actually required by the body for its proper functioning. Studies have proved that avoiding excessive eating or taking it only the required calorie diet has helped people reduce the blood sugar levels. What happens when your body reduces the calorie intake of food? Of course, one of the perks that is to lose weight. But at the same time, your body starts using the existing fat. The fat stored in your liver and pancreas decreases. This further helps the cell in the pancreas to release insulin. A person leading a sedentary lifestyle should not consume more than about 1200 to 1800 calories a day. However, counting on calories can be extremely tough and irritating sometimes. Therefore, we would like to suggest you very practical things that you can implement. Avoid overeating at all times. We all know when we are full, so no need to go through extra bite because of the peer pressure or craving. Secondly, use smaller plates, and third, eat slowly. I also advise you to make a diet plan based on your lifestyle and eat only the required calories a day. You can do this on our app. Second, increase your fiber intake. Fiber slows the carb digestion and sugar absorption. For these reasons, it promises a more gradual rise in blood sugar levels. Additionally, a high fiber diet can help better manage by improving the body's ability to regulate blood sugar and help reduce situation of extremely high or as well as extremely low blood sugar levels. Multiple researchers suggest that eating food rich in fiber has explicitly been shown to reduce blood sugar level by 5 to 10%. The recommended daily intake of fiber is about 25 grams for women and 38 grams for men. Foods that are high in fiber include whole grains, legumes, vegetables, and fruits. A complete list of fiber-rich food can be downloaded from our app. Third, shift to carb-free diet. Multiple researchers also propose shifting to a protein and fat-rich diet instead of carbohydrate or carbs. Carbohydrate directly gets converted to glucose and thus increases the sugar level in your body. When you eat carbs, your body uses it as fuels in the first place. But when you stop taking carbs, this triggers breakdown of fat and protein to release energy. This is called ketosis. For this, you can follow a carb-free diet. When you start a carb-free diet, previously stored body fat is also burned, which in turn results in immediate weight loss. However, carb-free is not for everyone. It depends upon multiple factors, including the level of ketones in your body, your diabetic level, and medications. You can consult a dietitian or diabetologist on our app to check for eligibility for this. Fourth, eat food with low glycemic index. The glycemic index, or GI, is a value assigned to food based on how slowly or how quickly those food cause increase in blood glucose level. Food high on glycemic index release glucose rapidly. Diabetic patients should eat food low in GI index as they tend to release glucose slowly and steadily. The slow and steady release of glucose prevents spikes in blood sugar and helps glucose control. GI values are generally divided into three categories. First, low GI, that is 1 to 55. Second, medium GI, that is 56 to 69. Third, high GI, that is 70 or greater. Apart from GI, you should also look at glycemic load. This depends on amount of carbs or sugar in that food. This value estimates how much food will raise a person's blood glucose level after eating it. 1 unit of glycemic load equals to the effect of eating 1 gram of glucose. In summary, consider both while making a food plan, the glycemic index and the glycemic load. As mentioned earlier, also look at the fiber content in the food. Considering all these factors, we would advise the following food to help reverse diabetes. First, whole grain. Whole grain include oats, barley and bulgur wheat. They should be primary component of the diabetic diet. Whole grain food that contains GI value of 45 instead of a normal grain with GI value of 77. These grains get absorbed very easily. Protein rich foods such as beans, lentils and legumes. For fats, you should prefer nuts and seeds and unsaturated oil like olive oil, sunflower oil, canola oil or soybean oil. Fatty fish like salmon, tuna or mackerel, nuts and seeds are always best. Non-starchy vegetables such as spinach, mushroom and broccoli and also capsicum. Fruits with low GI include all kinds of berries such as blueberries, strawberries, etc. Friends, most of us believe that we need to place food restrictions to win diabetes. But that is not the case at all. It's not about restriction, it is about the right replacement. There are thousands of fruits, juices and meals that you can have in diabetes. You can find that complete list on the Diabetes Mantra app. Not only that, if you're not able to find these food in the local market, you can also shop them at our app. So that's it for the food and diet changes. Next step towards winning your diabetes is lifestyle change. They play an equal important role in reversing your diabetes. Exercise regularly. Importance of regular exercise can't be undermined. Daily exercises reduce insulin resistance. Exercise activate your cells to accept and consume glucose or sugar running in your bloodstream. We would advise at least 30 minutes to 40 minutes of exercise per day to every diabetic patient. Start with brisk walking. Keep a target of 5,000 steps a day. Later, we would advise a combination of yoga, walking and other diabetes-friendly exercises. You can check out the exercises you need in the Diabetes Mantra app. Step 6. Reduce your stress level. Let's come to the next step in your reversal journey, that is reducing stress level. Stress gives rise to a hormone called cortisol. Cortisol acts opposite the action of insulin, that is, they prevent the movement of sugar from bloodstream to the cells. This results in higher blood sugar level. So in order to maintain your blood sugar level, you need to manage your stress. You can do this by maintaining a work-life balance, doing yoga daily and practicing meditation daily. Step 7. Get enough quality sleep. Getting enough sleep feels excellent and is necessary for good health. Poor sleeping quality and lack of rest can also affect blood sugar level and insulin sensitivity. They can increase appetite and promote weight gain. Sleep deprivation decreases the release of growth hormone and increases cortisol level. Both of these play an essential role in blood sugar management. As mentioned before, cortisol opposes the action of insulin and thus increases the blood sugar level. Furthermore, adequate sleep is about both quality and quantity. It's best to get a sufficient amount of good quality sleep every night. For adults, we would advise at least 7 to 8 hours of sound sleep. Step 8. Drink lots of water. Drinking enough water, even for a normal body, is very necessary. But when we talk about diabetics, it becomes even more important. Why so? When you drink lots of water, you tend to pee a lot, and your kidney flushes out extra glucose with the urine, hence maintaining the blood sugar levels. Also, drinking enough water reduces the risk of dehydration. What quantity of water would be enough for you? On an average, a diabetic person should take at least 10 glasses of water per day. Step 9. Practice fasting. Fasting for a diabetic patient? Sounds impractical and dangerous, right? We have always heard that eating in short intervals help you maintain blood sugar levels. Yes, it's true, but just for maintaining diabetes for all your life. And if you want to reverse diabetes, you need to fast. Fasting gives time to the pancreas to recover and increase the insulin sensitivity. It provides time to clean your body, that is, to detox it. Also, it would help in weight loss and lower the cholesterol. The most common type of fasting is known as 16:8 method, which involves fasting for 16 hours and reducing the eating window to just 8 hours. For example, a person can have dinner at approximately 7 p.m. and do breakfast at around 11 a.m. the next day. He's free to drink water and smoothies in the interim to keep him hydrated and active. A study conducted in Canada and published in the journal BMJ Case Reports suggests that intermittent fasting proves to be an effective method in reducing the blood sugar levels. Other form of fasting involves 2 days per week of fasting, 24 hours fasting once or twice each week, and fasting every other day. So friends, to summarize, let's repeat all the steps. Step 1. Implement portion control. Step 2. Increase your fiber intake. Step 3. Shift to a carb-free diet. Step 4. Eat food with low glycemic index. Step 5. Exercise regularly. Step 6. Reduce your stress level. Step 7. Get enough quality sleep. Step 8. Drink lots of water. And step 9. Practice fasting. Thousands of people across the world have been able to successfully reverse their diabetes by following the above steps. That said, diabetes reversal is a journey and requires commitment for at least 6 months to start seeing the results. Also, we understand that implementing these steps can be a daunting task. Friends, our aim at Diabetes Mantra is to help you inculcate these steps in for your life and support your diabetes reversal journey. There's a lot of free resources such as diet plans, recipe, exercise, and more on our Diabetes Mantra app. You can download it from Google Play Store and App Store. You may also visit our website diabetesmantra.com for these resources. I hope this video was informative for you and will help you in mission to reverse your diabetes. If you like this video, please do like and share. Subscribe to our channel for more informative videos. Thank you.